Hello and welcome to the tutorial for Ben Howard's Black Flies. Thank you for your support, thanks for donating, for buying the tutorial. Let's get started with the tuning. The tuning is CFC GGC from low to high and a capo on 3rd fret covering the high 5 strings. All strings but the lower E. In this case a C. C, F, C, G, G, C, capo, 3rd fret, covering the high 5 strings. Alright, and if you tune your guitar correctly, it should sound like this. You got it? Let's get started. Okay, let's get to the intro and the verse. Intro and verse are quite the same, so I'm going to show you what to play and then I'll break it down. That was a little variation. Usually Ben Howard plays but that varies. In the studio recording it's a bit lower, and in some of his live performances he plays this but I'm going to show you both. That's not a problem. Okay, let's get started. You start it with index finger on 4th string, 5th fret. Pluck it one time. Then you take your ring finger, put it on 7th fret, 4th string. Play it 2 times. And then you use your index finger, still on 5th fret, 4th string. Pluck it once and play a pull off. Alright? And then you use your ring finger on 7th fret, 5th string. Play it one time. And then you play 6th string open, you play that 3 times, and then after the 3rd bass note, the 3rd time you pluck the 6th string, you take your index finger on 5th fret 5th string. Release your ring finger from the 7th fret. And then play a pull off. Alright, every time you play that note on 7th fret, 5th string and 5th fret 5th string, you can give that a little bending, a little vibrating sound. Okay, until the pull off, and after the pull off you play 5 and 4 together open, and then you play 5 as a single note, and 5 and 4 together. Several times, about 4 times. I've heard that 8 times in a special live video, but that was a little bit boring. 4 times is enough, I think. Or two times, how you want it. Just listen to the version of Ben Howard. Play it three times, and then you get back into that. The part you've done before. Playing this thing here longer is just the transition to the chorus. Usually that's played about four times, and I heard that one played eight times, but that was really, really long, and I actually didn't like that. Yeah. This four-time thing was leading to the chorus. So play it three times. And then get back into that one. And now I'll show you the other variation with a higher bit. So you start again on 5th fret, 7th fret, 5th and the pull-off, that's exactly the same. And then you end on 7th fret, 5th string. Yeah. Sorry. You play the 7th fret, 5th string. Then you play one bass note on 6th open. And then you play 5th fret, 4th string. Alright? And then you play a hammer-on on 7th fret 4th string. And then you play 6 and 4 one after another. You play two times, 6-4, 6-4, and then you play 5th fret, 4th string, a single time, and a pull-off. Yeah, you release it, pull-off, and then you play 5-4, 5th string, and then 5th and 4th together. And the whole thing starts from the beginning. So, that's the way it is played in the studio version. Let's play that one time. Alright, that's the studio version. And in the live version, there's a higher bit. And that's what I'll show you now. You start like before. And now, again, when you're on 5th string, 7th fret, you play one bass note. And then you get up to 5th fret, 4th string. With that hammer-on on 7th fret. And now you go up to 8th fret 4th string, play it, and slide down to 7th fret. Yeah. You play it on 8th fret, 4th string, slide down to 7th fret. Then you take your index finger on 5th fret, 4th string again. And now you play a pull-off with your ring finger from 7th fret. And then you play the string open. Right? 4th 4 and 4-5 together, and then it's repeated like 4. You can play a bass note in between when sliding from 8th to 7th, play a bass note and then play the pull off from 7th to 5th fret. So all three variations, one after another. So, these are the three things you can play during the intro or verse, or better, the intro. And yeah, it's up to you to decide what you want to play. In the studio version, the intro is one time the low bit, then this high bit, but not the very high bit, just this one. And then the verse starts, and the verse consists of four times the lower bit here. And when Ben Howard stops singing, then there is the intro repeated again, like one time the low bit, and then this so in the studio version, this high bit with a slide down from 8th to 7th fret doesn't exist. That's a thing you play in the live versions, but I really like it. You can vary between that and gives a good sound. So that's basically the intro and the verse. Let's proceed to the chorus. Okay, the chorus. We ended up on playing 5 and 4 together. Single 5 and 5-4 together. And the chorus starts on 12th fret, covering the low two strings, 6 and 5, right? So, actually, the picking pattern is almost the same like before, right before the chorus, but in the studio version, Ben Howard plays it on 6 and 5. Yeah, 6 and 5 together. But that sounds a little bit thin in my opinion. I play 6 and then 6 and 5 and 4 together. And I've also seen that in a YouTube version of Ben Howard playing that song. But that's up to you how you like it best. Usually in the studio version it's just 6 and 5. On 12th fret, 6th and 5th string. And then after several times, changing from 6th string 12th fret to 6th string 10th fret. And then sliding down to 8th fret, 6th string, and the 5th is open. And that thing starts from the beginning, 12th fret. Alright, so usually 4 times this shape, 4 times this shape, and 8 times this shape. One time is serial and double, that's one time. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Alright, so that's what he plays in the chorus. Like I said, I like playing 6, 5, and 4 together instead of just 6 and 5, because that gives a better sound in my opinion. And well, it's up to you. And then the song starts getting easier, because the second time, when the chorus comes to an end and Ben Howard is on 8th fret 6th string, instead of plucking the strings right in the middle after 3 or 4 times plucking them, he starts to strum them. Right? Getting a little bit louder in the end, so he plays. And that leads directly into the next verse. Okay, the second verse. The second verse is actually played like the first one, but now everything is strummed. There's no picking again anymore. And now that's the only difference to the first verse. Instead of plucking 5 and 4 together, you hold down the 6th string on 8th fret. And now you strum down the first 3 or 4 strings. So, you start on 5th fret 4th string, one strumming down, then you take your ring finger on 7th fret 4th string, two strums, like 4 at 2 picks, no, it's 2 strums, and then you get back to 5th fret 4th string. One strum followed by a pull off. And then 5th string on 7th fret. 5th string on 5th fret. Again, this bending on 7th fret and 5th fret, and the pull off on 5th fret, and then 8th fret 6th string. And except the first few strums until you end up on 7th fret 5th string, you play 1 2 1 2 1 2, right? So that's quite simple. That's quite simple strumming. And that goes through the whole second verse. When I counted correctly in the studio version, he plays this this thing 6 times without any variation, without something like. That's not included, but you can play it after the singing, That's absolutely no problem. But in the studio version, it's not included. The strumming pattern when playing this variation stays exactly the same, so it's no problem for you to put that in there if you want to. Yeah, but that's the second verse, and the second verse ends up on that 8th fret 6th string and leads directly into the second chorus. The second chorus is exactly the same like the first chorus, the same shapes, 12th fret, 5th and 6th string, then 10th fret, 6th string and 12th fret, 5th string, and 8th fret, 6th string. Exactly the same like before, but this time it's all strummed. When the chorus is done, the chorus is about, I don't know, 40, 50 seconds, I don't know, a few times playing these shapes. When ending up on the 8th fret, on the 6th string, the strumming gets louder, it starts to rise, and you start to strum all the strings. That leads into the bridge. Right? And that's what we do next, the bridge. Okay, the bridge. We ended up on 8th fret, 6th string, strumming. Then we change our shape to ring finger on 7th fret 5th string and index finger on 5th fret 3rd string. The strumming pattern stays the same for the moment. But just on the shape here on 5th and 7th fret. Now we change that. We move up the whole shape from 5th and 7th fret to 8th and 10th fret. And then moving further up to 10th fret and 12th fret. Moving from 12th and 10th fret, your ring finger moving down to 10th fret on 5th string, and your index finger changed position from 10th fret to 8th fret 6th string. Alright? That's the middle part of the chorus, right? No, it's not. 8th fret and 10th fret. Now when strumming that down, we take our middle finger on 9th fret, 5th string, release our ring finger from 10th fret fifth string. And start the same thing from the beginning, right? First shape, still use your old strumming pattern, right? But prior moving up to the second shape, you do some more strumming, and that's something you have to listen to the version you wanna play. There is in the studio version. The first three shapes are quite simple to play. It's Just listen closely. I play it very slowly, so I hope you can copy that. It's very hard to explain how many strums you're doing and upstrokes, downstrokes, whatever. I'm just down strumming all the time now. And the last strum, I play the strings open before changing to that shape on 8th and 10th fret. And the next strum, I have the shape on 8th and 10th fret. This shape, and you play the calm version of that, you have the same strumming pattern as before, it is right, and then one time when you play that double strum, the first strum 8th and 10th fret. And the second of this double strum, the second strum, you have the middle finger on 9th fret, 5th string. And then you change position to the first shape again. So, that's the regular version. The calm version, and in the studio recording, this calm version is played about 3 or 4 times, and then it gets a little bit more hectic, a little bit louder, and this is now very, very difficult to explain. The shapes are exactly the same, like I showed you, but now he's not just playing these soft strums with just one finger, maybe. He's playing with his whole hand, and there are also changes between downstroking and upstroking. The first time we played them, now it was just downstroking, that was quite simple, but now we're playing downs and ups, and that's a bit difficult. First three shapes you can play in the regular way, just a bit stronger with downstrokes. That doesn't make much difference, but the last shape here on 8th and 10th fret, that's the one you hear in the studio version as up and down stroking very, very fast when he's changing from this position to this position. He's not just changing one time, but he's changing two or even three times. That's up to you. I've seen that varying very, very often from version to version. I know in the studio version it becomes very strong and there's some down upstroking on the last bit here. But that's up to you how you want to play it. And yeah, that's the bridge. And the bridge leads directly into the last part of the song. Okay, the last part of the song is the outro. So we played the bridge. Right? And to get to the outro, we just play a little bit softer. We stop playing these hard strums and play a little bit with more feeling, a little bit softer. And then we are in the outro, which is from the strumming pattern exactly the same. But we don't play these high notes here, we just play the low two or three strings, starting with index finger on 7th fret 5th string, and sliding up to 10th fret 5th string, playing a hammer-on on 12th fret 5th string, one strum after that hammer-on, slide down to 10th fret 5th string, and place our index finger on 8th fret 6th string. And here we play the same like before on 10th fret and 9th fret with ring finger and middle finger. And that goes through the whole outro and ends up on 5th string, 7th fret. That's the last note of the song. During the last time he plays this tune, he reduces the speed a little bit just to create the mood that the song is now over, and plays the last note on 7th fret 5th string with the low two strings. And as a little hint for the outro part, don't use your fingernail, because that gives a hard sound, and the outro is very, very calm, and you want that soft sound of the notes, and use your index finger, the side of your index finger and the fingertip, touch the strings with your skin, so you get that. So you get this comfortable sound and not this stretching noise, right? So that's the tip, that's the hint for you I have for the outro. And now the song is finished. Cool. Have fun playing. Thanks for watching. Thanks for supporting, And see you soon. Next tutorial is already in work.